I was overwhelmed by the size of the school and the faculties. In my old school, we basically used the same room for every subject. In this one, we had different rooms for different subjects. There was groups, labs, domestic science, there was textiles, food, the playing field, netball and tennis courts. And at my old junior school, there were 60 people in each class. Here, we have only 30 to 34, max. I mean, I felt so sorry for the boys and girls I've left behind. The girls had to get, like, a 50-minute walk just to get here, and the boys had to take a bus just to play football. No special rooms for the other subjects in my old one. In my old school, it was just grey building. Within the same grounds, just a schoolyard, outside toilets, etc., etc. In the dining room, I thought meals were quite good, and I thoroughly enjoyed them. As we got older, it was quite fun to see if any of the boys had left notes underneath the table covering. Gym and games. The changing room and shelves were a bit of a shock to the system, but at least we got warm after the long trek and the biting winds across the fields to play at hockey. All that fresh air must have made us healthy. After all, we only wore square knickers and neck blouses with navy blue knickers. Ugh. Sometimes, if it was very cold, we were allowed to wear a cardigan. Incidentally, why did those awful knickers have a pocket? I mean, what would we put in them? However, I did like climbing on the ropes and PE and hanging upside down on the wall bars. Needlework. We spent all our first year making a blue sewing bag to keep our work in. Pamela Feltrup still's got her, so I lost mine ages ago. And then we had to make an apron for domestic science. This was white with green bands, and our initials carefully embroidered on the pocket. The best bit for me was discovering an electric sewing machine. My old mum only had an old Jones sewing machine that you had to treadle. Music and art. I wasn't any good at either, but I still enjoyed the time spent in these classes. Science. Biology I was fine, and I did learn one important thing. I always thought that big frogs gave the little frogs a ride until I was introduced to their mating habits. Chemistry and physics left me bewildered. Maths. I am sure that some of you will not believe that I did like maths. I think that Miss Gay was my teacher for 4 years. Can't remember properly. I was terrified of her, but she was good at explaining things. It was a different world. We were expected to be polite, always standing up when a teacher came into the form room, answering her greeting before you were told to sit down. We did not run along the corridors. We were filed into the hall assembly without a word being spoken. We were expected to wear a uniform with pride. However, berets were a bit problem. As you can see, I'm not wearing mine. There's a good reason for that, I'll tell you now. The boys waited in the churchyard, and they got the little stalky bits of the berets. They chopped them off. I knew one boy who had a matchbox full of these little berets. They were like trophies, I guess. Nothing dull happened in the memory of the carol concert at Victoria Hall. It was the highlight of the school year. Past 3 o'clock on a cold, frosty morning, and it came upon a midnight clear. It was my favourite two songs. Just one thing puzzles me. Why wasn't I picked to be an angel?
When did you attend school?
I attended school until 1979.
What stories did older pupils tell you about pastors?
Oh, they used to tell me horrible stories, like the first day people shove your head down the toilet and pull the flush, and then you'd be tied to the flagpole, and you'd be dragged off into the roughs, and people used to chase you and hide your clothes, and lots of stories like that.
Did you have to pass exams in order to?
No, I didn't. It was a comprehensive school then.
What famous events took place when you were at school?
things. Well, we used to have speech days, which were really good. We had Michael Palin, and we also had our summer fair was opened by Olivia Newton-John, which she was in the she played Sandy in Greece, and she came to open our summer fair.
What were school dinners like?
They were pleasant. Yes, we used to have a cooked dinner in one half, and most people had that option. And then a new snack bar was introduced when I was in about the fifth form. And they sold burgers, and that was frowned upon.
What sort of homework did you have?
Lots. Lots and lots we used to have. You'd get most subjects, you'd get homework. So, and we used to have more lessons a day than needed. We used to have them in blocks of half an hour. But we used to have treble lessons sometimes as well. But yes, you used to get lots of homework.
What sort of school trips were there?
I went on one school trip to France, and we used to go on. We didn't go on that many school trips, but there was some to Italy, and there was one to France, and then we used to go on quite a few trips into town, but they were just on the bus.
What were the tests like?
The tests? You mean the end of year tests?
Yeah.
It was just everything you'd done in that year, really. But I always remember them being very, very hot. We used to do them in the main hall.
What was your school uniform like?
We used to have to wear a navy blue skirt, a navy blue jumper, a green and white checked shirt, and just for my first year we used to have to wear a tie, which was a green and blue striped tie. And we used to have to kneel down, and if your skirt didn't touch the floor when you knelt down, then it was deemed too short, and a letter was sent home.
Did you have to attend school till you were 16?
You had to, yes. Yes, you did. And you could stay until the sixth form.
Did you stay on until the sixth form?
I did.
What was it like and what did you study?
The sixth form was fantastic because having worn a uniform throughout the year, throughout all the other years, and then when you came into the sixth form, you wore your own clothes. So it used to feel like the bee's knees because you could walk around school in your own clothes. And I did ancient history, English art, and general studies.
What were the PE facilities like?
What is now the drama studios, that used to be our PE hall, and it was really new when I was here. And I really did enjoy sport, so it was great. We used to have, but the girls, we used to have to go in the dance gym, which is a smaller gym, and we used to have to wear leotards, which I didn't like. All girls had to wear leotards, and you have to have a navy blue knicker inspection in PE as well.
Was there any rivalry between High Stores and other schools?
Oh yes. High Stores and Silverdale. I mean, a lot of it was a lot of urban myth, if you like. People exaggerated stories, and if you believe them, there were lynchings, but there weren't really. But yes, you did get some students who used to fight on the field, or they'd arrange to meet in Enclave Park, and people just wouldn't turn up sensibly.
Who was your favourite teacher?
Mr Moore, who was my maths teacher, and Mr Scrivener, who was my art teacher.
Right, my name's Richard Downs. I first came to this school in 1986, the year of the hand of God, to Diego Maradona, for Argentina, and I lived nearby. I did not have to take any exams to get here. Well, some of the teachers are still here. One or two of the teachers are still. Mr. Cartwright taught me, and he's still here. Mr. Hayes was here when I came, and he was the one that everyone was scared of, but he's the one that actually everyone still loves now. No uniform when I came at all. Much the same now.
What were your favourite subjects?
You'll be surprised to know my favourite subject was PE, because it didn't involve any thinking. Other things, the field was exactly the same.
Did you stay on in the sixth form?
I stayed on the sixth form for about 4 years. I liked it that much, yeah. Yeah, so good I did it twice.
What was your least favourite subject?
Well, I remember the minute that I left the exam hall, I forgot everything about maths and physics, put it that way. I managed to scrape a C in both of those, and then I immediately forgot everything. So I'd probably say maths or physics were my least favourite.
What sort of punishments did they have at school?
Well, in the PE department, they had this thing called backslaps, where if you were naughty, then I won't name any names in case they get prosecuted, but they would actually get the individual that had been naughty out in front of the class and pull his shirt up and slap him on the back, which was all quite amusing, but it never happened to me, obviously.
Well, I first came to High Stores in 1972, which is a long, long time ago. And the school hadn't been a comprehensive school for very long then, so when I first came, it was still very evident that it had been two schools. One side of the school was the girls' school, and the other side of the school was the boys' school, and it was very noticeable that the girls' side of the school was much neater and tidier than the boys' school was. There was a very nice deputy head teacher then called Miss Freeman, only she couldn't pronounce her R's very well, so we used to call her Miss Freeman. And she was very, very kind, and she used to have a big jar of raisins in her room for pupils who had come to school without any breakfast, and she was always very concerned that it was really important that people had a good breakfast every day. There were four houses then, which you're going back into now, aren't you? Going to have four houses. And I thought the house system worked really, really well. There was Herring, Hoffman, Carey and Chadwick. And you were very loyal to your house, and there was a very competitive edge towards whichever house you were in, and all the sports and so on were very competitive between the different houses. We used to have a big prize giving in the City Hall every year, and we used to have a big carol concert in the City Hall every year. The whole school used to have to go to the City Hall, and it was quite tense and quite worrying that we'd all get everybody there and everybody would behave. We used to have some very famous speakers to our prize giving. One year we had Edward Heath, who was the Prime Minister at the time. What else can I tell you? Lots of... Oh, there was a uniform. Would you like to have a uniform yourselves now? What do you think?
When I first came here, I felt very weird not wearing a uniform.
Right.
And I did want one back, yes. Actually.
Well, the uniform, when I first came, was the girls wore a green and white check blouse, a beret, a green beret, and a navy blue or a black skirt. And the deputy head teacher that I was talking about, Miss Freeman, she insisted that the girls wore a purse belt, which was an elastic belt with a little zip purse in it, which was really a good idea because it meant that the money was safe, but the girls used to hate wearing the purse belt. The boys had to wear a blazer and dark grey or black trousers and the green and black strap tie. And when I very first came, it was very fashionable for the boys to have shorts, trousers that sort of swung around their ankles somewhere, like rather like the bands that were popular then were the Bay City Rollers and the Jackson Five and the Osmonds. They really liked bands like that, and the fashion was for sort of very chunky platform heel shoes and these stripy socks and trousers that were quite a long way above the ankles. So the fashions were very fun. The boys used to wear their ties very, very loose, very big tucked ties, not a down here, and really big collars on their shirts as well. So even though they wore a uniform, they still got round it to make it look very fashionable.
So what was it like to be head of sixth form?
Well, I thought it was the best job in the school, because by the time students have reached the end of Y13, that's the end of 13 years of school education. So I saw people who'd been all the way through junior school, infant school, junior school, secondary school, and then sixth form, and then they were ready to make the next stage in their education, so they were going to go on to bigger and better things, usually, in most cases. So I liked it, yes, very much.
What is your best and worst memory of High Stores?
Oh. Best. That's really, really difficult. I just think some of the happiest times with sixth formers when they got their results, particularly sixth formers, the results day. I really, really used to enjoy results days. I used to come in very, very early in the morning to pick up the results slips. And then the students themselves would start arriving from about 7:30 to get the results, and there was lots and lots of excitement and shouting and sometimes a few tears, but everybody was always very, very supportive. And in most cases, people had done really, really well, got the exam results they needed to go on to university to, or to go on to the jobs that they wanted to do. And it was just very exciting times, and really, you know, that was the culmination of everything that we've been working towards, so it was lovely that. Worst memories? I don't really know. I don't think I've got any bad memories, really. Perhaps sometimes when there were some especially naughty classes that were very difficult to deal with, but on the whole, the kids that I've taught at High Stores have been lovely and haven't been an awful lot of trouble, but just occasionally there's been one or two individuals who've been very challenging, but that's what teaching's all about, isn't it?
What sort of school trips and visits were there?
Oh, loads of things, absolutely loads. When I very, very first came to High Stores, we used to have a first year's picnic. That was for all of my set, and that was lovely. So we used to go out to Burbage Rocks and have take everybody out on coaches and go on a picnic. That was nice. Then we always used to have a sponsored walk every year, and that was good fun. We often used to have a big school fete. That was lovely. I went on a skiing trip to France once with some students. When I was head of sixth form, for many years we took the new sixth formers away to a youth hostel out in the Peak District just for a couple of nights to get to know each other before they actually started the sixth form. So lots and lots of things that I was involved in, but loads of things that other teachers did. Loads and loads of things.
And finally, what word or phrase would best